Majestic rider.
So today we're back on Sky. We're working, trying to get her running walk a little bit faster. She's only been here a week. This is her second week. But she has some talent, so I'm trying to get it out of her. She does get lazy sometimes, so I have to push her a little bit with my leg and with my stick. The other thing we're working on is her head carriage. Where is she comfortable? She's a walking horse, but she's actually built with a little bit of a low head and neck carriage. Natural for them to carry their head a little bit higher, but for her, it's more natural for her to carry it lower. So if she's here or if she's down, I did get a microphone, but I haven't figured it out yet. So if it's here or lower, that's okay. I just want to make sure she's doing the correct gait. And so I do have to push her. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to ask her to carry herself, and I'm going to keep releasing the rein because she's old enough and strong enough. She can do it herself. She just has to do it, and she's a little bit lazy, so she doesn't want to. So in the end, I don't want them on a tight rein. Some of them I have to keep on a little bit of a tighter rein in the beginning to help them know what to do. But then I want them to learn to carry themselves, so we're not in their mouth all the time. We might have a shorter rein than like riding on this, because this is much harder to control than when you're on the buckle. But we still want to have a little loop in the rein if we can. So here we go. So when I go by first, it will be slower, her flat walk, because I always like to go through the flat walk first, and then the next time around it'll be her running walk. And that was her flat walk, except she stepped on the pole. I'm trying to get close because I know you can't hear me when the wind's going, and hopefully that new microphone will help. So her biggest problem is when she comes out of her, they always want to talk when I'm on. When she comes out of her stall, she had 2 days off, she was a little fiery. So I had a round pender to get rid of that. The reason I want to get rid of some of that fiery part is I do want the energy for the walk, but I want her paying attention. And she's that amped up, she's not gonna pay attention. So I have to have her thinking. So I have to round pend her to get that energy out. Then she's on the pacey side. So I want to round pend her over these poles to help her get separating her legs. And occasionally she'll do some trotting steps or canter steps, and that's actually quite good for her because it's warming up, separating her legs. The poles are getting her to pick up her feet. It's also using her back and her stomach muscles, okay? Because she previously was just swinging her legs and not engaging and using herself, her back, and her muscles around her legs correctly, and that's what we're trying to get. So now as I ride her, she gets a little lazy, and then she doesn't, I ask her to go forward, and she doesn't give me enough energy. So then you'll see me tapping her with a stick, like, come on, you can go, we can do this, you can use yourself. So I want to use that energy
and get her to push with her back end to really drive. It's kind of the sensation of when you're going up a hill and you're walking and you feel that horse digging its feet in and pushing you up the hill. That's the feel of like they're engaging their back end. You're getting impulsion from the back end. You're getting what they what's called strength, okay? So we're just using different words for it, but we want her to engage her back end, to use those muscles, and then to carry herself so I don't have to carry her the whole time. I wanna set her up for where she's supposed to be so she knows, and I wanna tell her this would be a good place to put your head. I don't want it too low on the ground or she's gonna get heavy on her front end. So I want her to be in a spot which is good for her confirmation. So I don't want it too high and I don't want it too low. I want it somewhere neutral for her. And if she picks it up, that's okay because she'll get more head shake, but I definitely don't want it too low because she's built just a little bit downhill. So overall for the second week, I think she's doing good besides her walking behind me, testing and moving around, right? So, and for the first day back to work after the weekend off, that's quite good. So some of you I know like to just jump on your horses and go, and then you have all these issues with pacing, them acting up, they won't stand still. If you would just round pen them for 10 minutes or lunge them or run them around in an arena, it'll help with all of those things. And I get lots of people come for lessons and I go, they tell me what their problems are and I go, do you round pen them or lunge them? And they go, no. I go, but you see my videos. Yes. But you don't know. I go, okay. So those things would help a lot and take care of those things. Because everybody thinks, oh, you just lunge them or round pen them if it's a crazy horse. No, it helps to warm them up, warm their muscles up, gets them to be less pacey, gets them to be less spooky. It does many, many things for you. And you get to see your horse move to make sure it's not lame, that it's okay. And you get its mind ready to work. It's kind of like I get up and I have a cup of coffee and I have to sit there and I really do have to wake up. I'm not someone who jumps out of bed and I'm ready to go. So I have to have my coffee. A lot of these horses need that round pen or lunge line to get them ready to go to work or run around the arena, get them ready for work. And then I'll get some questions like, I heard the round pen's really bad for their legs, or I heard lunging in a circle is really bad for their legs. You can make a bigger circle. You can put them in on a 30-foot lunge line. This is a 60-foot round pen, so it's quite big. But in the end, I want to be safe. And I want them to ride well, but I also want the most important part is you're safe. And so I'd rather have them get older and have a little arthritis or something from running around that round pen than them killing me. So you have to weigh the good with the bad and the benefits, and you have to use your own judgment. But I'd much rather have a horse gait better and pay attention and be calm and round pen it than versus not round pen it or lunge it and have it be crazy, spooky pace and just a horrible ride. That's my opinion. But overall, she did quite well today, except she just wants to go back to that horse that's screaming to her.